After falling victim on their map pick of Nuke, Heroic, bouncing back in miraculous fashion here on Overpass, not with one, no, but two overtimes launders. This man, Kadian, a hell of a difference maker at times, especially in that last round on the CT side. Oh, it was a thing of beauty, and it's more beautiful because it leads us to the third and final map. That is right, folks, we're heading.
Trained, train.
Which means now, all of a sudden, I feel like the AWP becomes all more important.
It does. Yeah, it gets more intense with the AWP. I mean, Kadian was like, I think 50% of his last few rounds in AWP shots were all no-scopes.
Yeah, something like that,
something
right?
Something like that, yeah. I think that's the exact stat, but yeah, he was going off. There was, I think everybody is starting to light up a little bit. Everyone was just getting nice and warm.
Well, you could just tell like the whole server was kind of getting heated. Even like the you know, you just mentioned those no-scope kills. Well, yeah. The reason they're no-scope kills is because he's in a situation where, you know, he's getting rushed outside of bathrooms. Yeah. In the second one, he's catching a player on a desperate rotate while he's also trying to get into the next spot. It's like nobody quite knew what was going on. It was hectic, it was chaotic, but it was Heroic who end up coming out on top, and that's all that matters, because Overpass is behind us, Train is what lies ahead, and that's why we need to now set our sights on it. And I think personally, coming into this series, I kind of had North, but when it boils down to Train, I like Heroic's odds.
You like Heroic? I really liked AZ, actually, on Overpass. I thought he was doing a lot of cool stuff.
Yeah.
I loved MSL.
Borup.
Borup, though, yeah, Borup was awesome, and Borup Kadian. So there's, I think like it's a bunch of players who are all starting to get really, really warm.
Yeah.
And like some stories are the same. MSL remains consistent. He is keeping his product at like the most appealing. Mm-hmm. Kadian is getting really good with the AWP right now. I mean, he wasn't really dropping shots ever, but is even better. And there's so many things that are going really well. I think we have a recipe for a fantastic series to end here on Train.
Yeah, Stown was going for that knife clutch. Of course, map 3 decided by knife, so you guys saw it. Screens within screens. North will have the choice of sides. You can only imagine, Mohan, that they opt to hit the defense first. That puts everything into question. You know, how much has North gone over when it comes down to Train? It's a new roster with MSL recently at the helm.
Yeah.
Everybody else is gelled. You know, they've had time to do that, absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, it's tough. We don't know how they feel about it. Yeah, that's for sure. But we do know they all can play it. Everyone
absolutely
in the server knows how to play Train.
And at this point as well, it's like nobody gets any passes, in my opinion, in terms of form at this point.
Yeah.
You know, both these teams have been here all day long. The practice areas, I've been walking by, been lit up. Everybody's still around, you know, and these guys are no exception. So.
Yeah, that's true. There's so much that can happen. It's going to be a very tight experience. We haven't seen Train yet so far.
Nope.
And as a decider, I think it's really close to 50-50 for me. I really don't even know who I have as a favorite. I'm not really sure. I don't know what MSL is going to bring to the table, how much they actually accomplished in the boot camp, how much of that emphasis was on Train, if any at all. And how much they were expecting to go to the third map in the series from both these teams.
Yeah, I mean, there was a moment where I felt like North had locked that down when they were able to finish off the first half of Overpass with a few more rounds. You know, they seemed in control of it, but it was really those middle of the half moments where Heroic were making the most of it. And that's what matters, you know, the meat and taters. What's right there in the center. And, my head is still trying to comprehend everything we saw in Overpass.
There's a lot. Yeah.
I feel like a part of me should also just be looking forward, because again, it's over, it's done. But what lies ahead is such a question mark when it comes down to Train. That's why it's exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I'm reading in-game chat.
Yeah, I think we're just deciding on
North
something.
North switched to the T side and maybe didn't want to.
Okay, interesting.
They want to reset it. I don't know. It's in the admin's hands. I ain't no admin.
Yeah. No, I wouldn't want to be one either.
Nope.
Going to make the hard decisions.
Yep.
I'm not interested in that. I'm interested in talking about hard decisions.
Yeah. I like to criticize hard.
I like to be the arbiter of hard decisions.
Yeah.
But not the guy who has to rep the repercussions.
Okay. So this is real.
Okay.
We are jumping into Train.
Right as the song ends.
And North will start on the T side.
Sounds good. It doesn't make a difference.
No, man, you switch it half.
You gotta play both halves, yeah. Like, it's like, oh, but what if you end 14, 14-1.
Yeah, well, you
like,
deserve
to lose. You were going to lose later, so just be thankful it ends early.
So here we go. Without any further waiting, folks, let's jump into the final map of day two here in Leipzig. I know there's still some of you out there keeping an eye on the action. I've heard you loud and proud. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, they're out there. Counter-Strike's a hell of a drug, huh? Estetag, 3 headshots, Snappy with 1. Gade, the only player able to respond here for North thus far. They'd love to just get this plant down. When things start going south, oh, cash out! But the cash cow runs dry. Heroic taking pistol, no plant.
Oh, wow. Yeah, the cows grow thin. That's it. They don't even get the bomb plant, which is so critical these days. With the economy and the state that it is, they don't get to pull off that buy. And it affects the buy of the CTs too. They know that every team is going to be buying on that second round. I mean, especially in this matchup. And now they're going to pick up 3 SMGs instead and collect tons of cash. And Norris will just like to get another plant, minimal losses. But what's probably going to happen is they all just get absolutely mowed down by these tiny weapons.
Little garden hose of an MP9. Shoulder peeking with a molly ready.
Late grenade. Oh, but it's still pretty okay.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Worth the $300.
Yeah.
Here they come, flooding out from above on the B site. Borup tucked in, has dropped the bomb and added 3 frags to the feed. Gade will be the last alive yet again, just like Pistol. And hell, he's gotten himself 2 kills with just the Glock. Substantial damage versus Cadian. But it is the conversion from Heroic.
Mm-hmm.
3 survivors.
Not bad, yeah. Like, not bad from both sides in that regard. You don't expect to get 2 kills to the Glock. But the bomb plant was worth way more. And they just weren't very favored to do that. They saved a lot for this round.
Yep.
And they're going to invest fully into it. They've gone right for the SGs and will go right for the throat.
Ye old Krieg.
Round 3. First rifle round here. It's a default. They want to know what Heroic are going to do. They're the ones who haven't had the suffer to the upgrade. Wow, the spray down for Mesotag to combine with this fire damage.
Yeah.
On top of all that, and it's super effective.
Yeah, just a really nice sequence of grenades there in T-Con. You saw the initial Molotovs hitting the back entrance, forcing them into that closer corner, and then a molly on their feet that forced them into the open. So a 2-piece there with the flames. North forced to run into their deaths.
Tough situation. With AZ on that default, they wait. They want to see if there's going to be a push. If the CTs are going to try to reclaim T-Con control later on in the round, they just want to make sure no one can go there early before they start to go off and do things. But they were, I think, enticed to make a play they didn't really sign up for. Cajun coming in late to try to take out Dawn. And there's a chance to do it. Still might lose. Has to go through the smoke. Someone close right, does he hard clear this angle?
Come on now.
He goes high, but also lands drive for him. We'll end it with some body shots, and Heroic are off to the quick 3-0.
Yep, dispatching that first gun round, the weapons of which North saved 4 in the second. So now, start to question, what are their ecos looking like? That's the tag, full blind, just mowing him down. That's 3 bodies piling up outside of T-Con.
Yeah, it's been good up here. Close spray downs, and North have picked up deagles. That's just a little bit of a leash that they have for themselves in round 4 on this eco. And try to do some damage. It's a series of small ops, right? They're going to move. They're going to probably stay somewhat spread apart. If they get an entry, might follow up to it, but if not, oh, there. They've actually gone for the tag. Gade had a small chance there to just like nail something, very unlikely, and then his teammates were going to be separated from him.
Yeah.
But at least they get a kill.
Last time when met by that molly, they tried to flood out from above, but I feel like tagging that player one time can sometimes slow them down enough to where you can rush and catch them. Clearly not the case here in the 4th round. But Snappy keeping eyes on Ivy, and as he should be, Garby's coming out to challenge this. Just a beagle in a tenured attempt, but a frag nonetheless.
Reloading in plain sight just to pull that peek because he saw Kirby poking around.
Yeah. Now, obviously, bomb cut off from its attempt at T-Con. Found looking to add some kills to the scoreboard, and he will do so with ease. 4-0 start for Heroic, but we do get into the next gun round, and you can't, of course, right off the op. This time MSL has it.
Yeah, let's see what he can do, how he's feeling, if he's going to feel fresh here on T-side train. It's one of the hardest maps to get the T-side op kills on, something that like people like Device are a master of. You just got to watch their demos if you want to learn anything. The way that he engineers kills, even though everyone knows how he plays, they'll always be astonishing, honestly. But MSL has been also great at finding T-side openings on a lot of other maps that we've seen so far.
Yeah. Device, the best player in the world, but not really.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, Tom Cruise is my number one this year, but I don't know.
Already falling off of upper B. The hip hop, and we haven't even seen North get out past T-Con yet. They've never been in Sandwich, they've never taken bottom ladder control. It's been this forward positioning from Heroic to hold the line, but it is early days.
There's a way out of to the top of Ivy, an easy split that could happen. If they have the intention of going A, this could be an opportunity. Now, that's obviously the Man 5 train watching.
Yeah, on the side of Brown. So if somebody even just jumps out, let's say the first player jumps out and MSL goes for the shot here, there's a world where somebody slips by. Ooh, he hits the shot, but doesn't get the kill. Tragedy. Kierby gets one, but it's still a solid hold coming out of Heroic here. Nobody able to exit Pop Dog. Test attack. Pool. Tried by.
Okay.
And a follow-up. Now he's feeling it. And this would be the time for him to come alive because he struggled on Overpass.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did.
And I mean, he struggled on Nuke too.
Way more on Nuke. Less so on Overpass. And looks like he's all unrusted here. So that's what we want to see. That's beautiful. Nice little drive-by.
If he's saving that fresh face for map three launders, I don't think his teammates will complain.
No, since they got here.
Yeah. Flawless start to the CT side. Yeah, Heroic. 5-0 and versus pistols yet again.
That was fine. They just had the op at Ivy, and they actually had the read on the setup that since there was no one there, no presence at all, no nades that came their way, it was probably someone holding it from 5. That guy didn't have an op to his hand, so there was a chance to just get that kill easy and then make it really difficult for his teammates outside, but it was the 85 damage shot, either in the legs or through the side of the train, so it's kind of tricky. Snappy did a good job of tucking himself in and obviously nailing the kill, most importantly. Crossed at Ivy. Oh, if he scoped in a little bit sooner, maybe he goes for that. Gets it.
Whoa, dodging Deagle shots. Dropped to 31 HP, and here's an entry. Two frags, in fact. That one Galil kill, and the Deagle's able to push past Sandwich, but he walks into the scoped off of MSL. Hell of a gun to get his hands on. Nice grenade from Cadian, and he follows up with a follow-up kill that puts him and his teammate in the even 2v2, but his attention, all of that of North drawn towards Cadian. Borup's looking to sideline somebody. Playing with this grenade. He's gonna flush Kierby off of his spot. Not rushing the bomb plant, but the smoke's gonna start to fade, and the longer they take, the closer Cadian gets to coming out from Pop Dog, and these T's have no map control other than the bomb site. Borup sees them both, and he's just gonna call that for Cadian. So the big question is, does Gade anticipate the peak? Seems not likely. Yeah.
Put that back on.
Yeah, careful, it's round 6. But not any round 6.
Yeah.
The 6th in a row here from Heroic.
That's true in a row, yeah. Very important 1v1, just to maintain the momentum. Yeah. Step, keep that foot on the throat.
I understand why Cadian pops off. No, I'm just kidding. The frag grenade thrown towards Ivy that blows out MSL, takes back one of those guns, and then that quick shot onto E-Box and an immediate rotation. I mean, that's just excellent utility, awesome op shot, and a big brain clutch play.
Yeah.
That's an all-in-one package there for Cadian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Definitely a lot of good to talk about. Yeah. Okay, so they go back to the drawing board here. Was that a save? Was that a save round turned awry for North?
It definitely wasn't all in, 100%
not. Oh, no. Okay, because they're buying...
Okay. There's probably some Deagles in there, maybe a CZ.
Yeah.
Flash, perhaps.
Right. Yeah, they've got the full buy out now, though. Yeah, they've got all the SGs in the op and all the grenades and a little bit left over for the savings account for the piggy bank. So they got close enough. They got a pace of it. Maybe see a path to victory. But is it paved?
far, so good. The road's been smooth. Cadian, okay, man. The confidence from the last round boils over here into the seventh one. He's in the flow state, Launders.
Good nade. Oh, very good grenade. Almost perfect. Break. What was the timing from that last round, Snappy? Just tuned into it. Free damage.
I love the aggression coming out of Heroic. They've always been at the front of this A bomb site. I mean, this Brown Hall's peak from Cadian in this round comes out of nowhere.
This is where it gets worse. You know, Snappy had a worse gun last time. Oh my god.
Move.
Moving
get out
in front of him. Cadian is just like,
yeah,
what the hell, dude?
He hasn't died yet. He's
I'm in. He's like, I'm watching that, dude.
I am God. No one can stop me.
I don't know how nobody dies in that situation.
Yeah, it's quick. Not just the fact that he runs into them with a smoke in his hand, but the fact that he blocks Snappy's view as well. Man. Like I said, he's zoned in at the moment.
Yeah.
Deep smokes both on Ivy and T-Con at the 30-second mark. I mean, the fact that they had so much map control without burning those grenades. Heroic are in a prime spot to keep the spree a-rolling. You talked about how it's difficult to get that T-side op in play. Well, MSL is currently sitting at 1-6. His second round with the sniper. Still empty-handed, and there are two scope guns on the other side. But here's Estetag giving his position away, and it doesn't matter because Snappy is just adding kills to the count. Three frags for him.
Snappy has Ivy wrapped in his vines.
Yeah.
He knows every single move that they're going to make. He knows when he's even free to not look at it. He's got it handled from the back of five to playing at Ivy. He knows where to throw his grenades earlier on in the round, the perfect timing to maximize their efforts, and he hasn't been a standout player individually in this series, but right now he's having an incredible impact.
Cadian still yet to experience death on train. Man, the gull for him, after the pause called from MSL,
mm-hmm.
to just run into Brown Halls completely alone with the op. And not just like, say, you know, you can go aggro op peaks in upper B, but sometimes you'll get it from the upper shelf with somebody on ramp to
someone
try and
mollies you.
Yeah,
and you take 30 damage, you don't waste time.
He just plays it as close as he could. The party keeps
oh my goodness, the red bars. That is a bloody disaster. Inside of T-Con, I think, and then everybody just flees and scrambles. They had a bunch of utility that they were going to use. I don't know if they were going to try to perform a running execute off of that. You know, this is a round where people have armor. You know, there's something on the line. Players drop into Ston's hands. He doesn't pull down and left for that spray. He gets left in the dust as Acetag comes in for the free ADR.
Snappy's op's been on point. Kirby, though, he could get line of sight.
Snappy's been so careful. He's been so careful. So aware and so careful at Ivy.
He's on, like, the other end of the spectrum to Cadian. Oh, but it's still working. Both of their tactics, both of their styles, both of which, with that AWP, he even hits the leg shot on
the
Kirby. Frag's gonna, not finish him off, but now he knows he's close.
Yeah, he knows where he is.
Which means the bomb just gets gifted to him. It's like, so be it. It took a second bullet. You get more for the reward. Estetag up in the office. Just signing checks, baby. Eight rounds in a row here for Heroic. Poor North.
Damn, dude. North, it seemed like had the series wrapped up. Didn't really feel like that Heroic were going to be able to come back into a third, let alone be able to just like close it out this dominantly. But look at Snappy go, man. He is so comfortable. And it's also, he's being quite a static opper in comparison to Cadian when it comes to like the story of a whole round. Cadian is moving around from the B site to the A site, whereas Snappy has relatively paid only attention to Ivy. Though here, he does nail the first one down in T-Con as a teammate climbs up the ladder like Spider-Man to get a higher line of sight, and Snappy's now got his eyes back on his typical angle, deep into this thin line of sight at Ivy. And Cadian's actually one taking a passive shot that will be successful. It's into Cajun B, but into his legs.
Yep. He's going to have to limp deeper into the upper halls here. Cadian calling for Borup to come support him. It's wild, man. I feel like I've seen North on a bomb site maybe once or twice.
Yeah, they're definitely not making it out of these choke points easily. Yeah, it's
never with an advantage.
Yeah.
So this could be it, though. They do have bodies stacking up at B. The majority of heroics still on the other side of the map. Great flash. It's going to counter Cadian for the time being, but Morup's presented two 1v1s. Sure, he's executed from above, but that primes Cadian into play. However, Kierby could be the difference maker here. MSL jumps in, off in hand, already scoped, hoping that a CT gives themselves away, but they know what he's up to. So the trade frag's back and forth. 30 seconds, bomb down. Kierby has to prioritize plant. Can he walk away with the clutch? There is no utility left on either side of this. Just rifles in hand. Through smoke. Kierby knows that they're there, but he can do nothing about it. 9 in a row for Heroic. Nothing stops them.
Man, snappy, another three-piece right there. Borup, though, fantastic hold. Him and his teammate, who were holding, had the AWP plus the Molotov that came his way to support him. Borup, as he saw the patience, as he watched his opponent fly up into the air, just carefully picked the point where his head would be and then blew it off and then turned it into a 2K. That was nice stuff. And again, snappy opening kill, as well as final two.
Yep. Superb.
The opener and the closer. 9-0. Wow, and North, yeah, they really just can't find a way out. I mean, that's the closest they came with that 1v1 clutch that Cadian had popped off an outside.
Yeah.
That was the very closest, and that was not even a full buy round.
It's wild.
Always a bad sign.
That's a round where North, where Heroic survived with one player. The most recent round, we have North surviving with two players, and every single other round has been three at least, mm-hmm. with the majority being four or five.
Right.
You know, like there's really not even been openings here for North at all.
Best half that they can get is 6 now, and it doesn't seem like they're going to get anywhere close to that.
I mean, if there's anything, you know, a silver lining perhaps is like we've seen them at times just scrape away those last few rounds of sides. So Heroic, they can't get into that mindset where it's like we've done a good enough job to let things slip.
I don't think they're scared.
No,
yeah.
No. I assume they're
really worried. There's another great nade from Snappy. Oh, what? Oh, wow. It actually goes like, a bit too far.
And like bounced off the top of his head.
They've moved up.
Yeah, this is the chance. This is the one round where I think maybe they get through Ivy. Snappy, he's going to let them get way too close. Doesn't have his AWP to stop this, so the A site's compromised. For one of the first few rounds I can remember, we actually have North with a man advantage, and they're setting these CTs scrambling, but Sound does have himself in a decent spot. He could come back behind these keys, just clamber back into the man advantage, but nope, he's dealt with. So a 4v2 ensues, and Heroic, they seem to have let one slip. Estetag try as he might, it was Ivy the solution. Getting Snappy off of that AWP, getting close up into his face, and then swarming the A site right after the frag. That's the one thing that's worked for North.
Yeah, but they didn't even like get him off the AWP, right? He chose to get off the AWP. Yeah. Like they never even lose the round with him playing there. In that previous round as well, he started off with the AWP, got the AWP kill, and then when it came to the late round, the 2v1,
he swapped the weapon. Didn't get his AWP back, maybe?
Yeah, just didn't pick up the AWP again. So I don't know when he dropped it, but that was kind of a problem. I think the weird part was when the peak came out, he wasn't even shooting. I don't know if his gun locked up because he had just switched and clicked too early.
Yeah.
But that was a little bit weird. But yeah, they got close enough that they could have come out with at worst a 1-for-1 trade.
Forgot to turn the safety off.
Maybe that's why.
It happens.
Yeah. Good thing I don't have that key bound.
Yeah.
Never run into that issue. Yeah, the problem is like, That's literally, I mean, at least North identified that, like, if they get Ivy, they can win.
Sure.
It's just that Snappy's been way too good at it. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if they want to try to fight him again. Maybe Kirby's feeling a bit more confident. He's had a few rounds. You know, he's visited Snappy's house a few times now. He kind of knows where all the furniture is.
Yeah.
He can maybe figure out a way to trick him once again. And he likes to work by himself, too. So I wouldn't be surprised if he tries to go at it alone. Cadian drops a shot. Small flick downwards that he can't quite connect with. Takes some damage from the Molotov that came his way. He falls back with just a little bit of information.
Yeah, well, at least they know that they've forced him to evacuate the box halls. Of course, there is still someone to linger outside Ivy, but Snappy is back on that AWP.
I think Kirby's like, all right, listen, I'm going to feign this presence. I'm going to actually come in.
Sure.
Oh, they're going to come. Oh, I thought he was going to come up Ivy late.
Cadian drops his smoke, just hoping that they won't execute through it. Well, that would put a lot of pressure on Borup, but we know North have four members primed in this upper B site. 55 seconds. Smoke plumes a second time. Luckily, it's not as though North had thrown utility in between those. So, nothing wasted, just time burned. Then Heroic, well, over on that A site, initially they had players on the bomb site, and now they've actually pushed those players forward, so they'll have an early warning system if there is this late rotate back towards A, but a nice shot from Cadian to cut one off of the ramp. It is A, the target, in fact. Estetag's gonna get pinched, but oh, Staffy gives him cover still. A sketchy situation there for Estetag. Luckily, it's Snappy, the man who's locked down Ivy and now this A site in its entirety. He does it again with the AWP. 13-3.
They're actually having trouble with the timings on the crunches outside, because like there are times where Estetag is available to die, but they're not squeezing him from ladder and TCon at the same time. If they did, they'd come out the trade a lot faster. He could have definitely died if not for Snappy, but he should have died anyway, I think. But yeah, they were just the timing is not perfect, so it feels like they're just not well oiled on the executes, or as well oiled as they should be. They certainly look like they're a bit slow to come to their teammates' attention when they're coming out of these choke points. Again, it makes you wonder if, you know, Ivy is just like probably the easiest way for them to deal with this. But again, Snappy continues to be dynamic. He's in a new spot that round.
Hero AK here from CRB. See if he can get into the mix, but I mean, it's an all-in here from TCon. I'm just gonna wait out some smokes, use that one flash, and just try to burst into Olaf. But hold on, hold on. He's gonna change route. As opposed to throwing it over TCon, I was thinking maybe he goes and blows out the windows on ladder and does it, but doubles back again? What is MSL up to? Original game plan, there it goes. That's their one chance to exit, and it's an effective flashbang. Sam's gonna feel the pressure here, but him and Snappy, again, just combining to lock this down. Dude, there is no solution to Snappy.
Yeah, he continues to be a problem. Like, he cannot really be stopped that easily. And yeah, he's just having way too much impact for, like, how good his teammates are. But he's also in the positions that North have put the most amount of emphasis on, right? They're shining a light on Ivy. It's just that they're just not able to take him out.
These three A players have 40 of the 57 kills on the side of Heroic.
Right, yeah. This is where they're going.
Nobody's getting past them. Snappy's only died three times. They are running out of chances. Desperate at this point for anything. And even when they try to get over here towards B, sometimes one is cut down. It's Cadian again. If he's not aggressive, he's peeking up from ramp. At least Kierby's found some footing outdoors. This could throw things into question, but Cadian again. The AWPs here for Heroic are just on point. Smoking hot. Deep frag grenade meant to chip away at the bomb plant, but again, so be it. They planted a bomb. At this point, plants aren't enough. You need the rounds. And unless AZ's gonna clutch a 1v4, it's just not gonna happen, and he can't. Down with the high road, takes them down 12-1, Launders.
Yeah, the early round's not successful. They're actually getting killed by Cadian way too often in those positions. Like, he should be free to take those frags. They just shouldn't be able to come so often, especially if they're in some of the similar spots. And he's just getting more and more confident at doing them, especially like the pushing all the way up the steps to standing in the doorway. The one flash is enough to get him off of the angle, yes. Once he re-peeks, he is offered up a shot. I mean, even though they had the double peek, there was no answer, no ability to trade. So maybe it's not safe to try to attack him that way, but instead just wait him out to make sure he gets back in the site before you move on. Because you're just giving up a free kill,
sure,
making the round a lot harder for yourself. And it seems like that is one of the many issues right now, on top of just like difficult to play against players.
Fourth and final timeout calls here. North doing everything they can to try and solve this T-side issue.
They're losing the early round to Snappy, Estetag, and Cadian. All of like the main choke points. Estetag's taking on two choke points at once, playing as the E-box, like forward aggressive player outside. Snappy at Ivy when they try to lurk up is winning his duels more often than not. And Cadian's getting these early round picks that shouldn't happen either.
Yeah.
Some of them are very quick and very nice. You've got to give them credit, but it's just limit those opportunities if you're North.
full confidence at this point. Kadian gonna run over towards Ivy, deep smokes it, runs back through Z over towards B. That's three players out of the gates here for Heroic on the inner bomb site. Sound comfortable. They know that because of that smoke over towards Ivy, that North are gonna have to use utility, giving away the audio cues, and therefore Heroic, they can base it on timing to rotate someone back there and try to plug the gap in the back hole.
Butt plug maneuver.
Yeah, essentially. Each their own. But they're also moving forward as fast as can be. Look at this. Estetag just up into T-Con, confident as ever, and why not? I mean, you're sitting at 12. Yes.
I mean, that's Counter-Strike, right? Okay.
Yeah. Good trades. Let's go. There's the exit. And more importantly, the exit with bomb. So that could be an easy plant. A plant with a man advantage, perhaps, if Cajun's got just running in the open. Kind of blindsided there by Stown. There's a flank up from Pop Dog. So the fourth man, AZ, is going to probably have to keep eyes behind. He is smoked off from ramp as well. Nobody's watching flank, and Stown's just walking up on the retake already. If he taps that bomb, he is going to make them panic, make them rush. And AZ will run into the site. Here comes Estetag catching MSL with his knife in hand, and AZ looking to it, but nope. Another for Heroic. 13 rounds on this CT side.
Even when they are able to kill Snappy for free like that off of the most beautiful timing that you've ever seen in your life, they still cannot get a successful post-plant situation. They weren't even at an advantage at any point there. At best, 3-3. Trades are instant now for Heroic. Really good. Well, it feels like they're even lucky to have one. They've got moving in the last round, potential 14-1 half.
No, boy, don't do it to him.
Okay. Oh, yeah, the Dak Dak.
Oh, is he gonna juggle it? Oh, you little rat. Oh, where's he bringing that? Like, as if MSL wasn't tilted enough. He's got it on the depths of the B bomb site. So if you run down that ramp, yeah, you are mincemeat. Swiss cheese.
Holy smokes.
Speaking of cheese, Estetag, are you really gonna try to pull that off? Oh! What? And now they're gonna fall down on him and oh man, imagine if he walks away with more. I mean, he's lucky to get just one. Throws a spanner in the works. 4v4, not the worst position North has been in throughout this half. But it is desperate. They need that second round. Great flashbang. Kadian sets down up for one. That bomb's been thrown onto the dirt, so information given away, and AZ doesn't collect it. He just leaves it there. He's got to double back for that. Kierby, that's a crucial duel. Now, if they can split this A site from all three directions, you'd think Kadian's screwed, unless he somehow finds godlike timing on these three Ts. Now, those shots out T-Con, that's going to be information, so he starts hunting that kill instead, and AZ hasn't made a move. Ladder's heard. Kadian. He's trying to keep his eyes in all directions, especially with Kierby coming off of ult bomb. And there it is, he's finally taken down. Amazing he has still survived in that situation. No one had eyes on him, but Borup, one last chance. North, one last round, potentially there. He's out and down for the count. 13-2 is the half. Is that last round enough to keep North in this? It would take a miracle. But Counter-Strike is made of magic. So we'll see you guys after the break for the second half.
Thank you.
DreamHack Open dropping epic tracks in between halves, because that was an epic blunder from North's tee side.
Yeah, it was.
Two rounds, one of which comes in the very final attempt on that tee side. They are going to feel the heat in this pistol, because a lot hinges on this. Heroic, 13 rounds on the defense. I'm just happy that their auto sniper didn't get any kills.
I know, right? Like, that act didn't come into fruition. Just to put poor salt on the wound.
Here we go, Launders. They absolutely need this. Strong utility for MSL, close on this B site. A crucial pistol round, awesome boost.
That's why they call him Snappy. That P250.
Oh my god. And all these people just fall into the bomb site. MSL, try as he may, is gonna find nothing. So it's a bomb plant and a 5v2 on top of that for Heroic to secure a 14th round. They had to go to double OT on Overpass. If you missed that, I mean, first of all, shame on you.
Secondly,
it looked nothing like this. A total one-sided affair here in the decider map. But hold on. This pistol's not yet over. Oh, not at all. From 2v5 to a 2v2, they're just gonna sprint in on this. That bomb's still able to be defused, but oh, no trade frag. Down nearly seals the deal. 14-2.
He does, the Stone Dawn. Here he is. Really nice with him. And it seemed like, yeah, they were just gaining some momentum back, and he goes ahead and just handles that by himself, splits open the complete 90-degree crossfire. Perfect stuff from him. And Heroic, yeah, it's just two away from wrapping up the series, and it looks like that's how it's the tail of the tape is going to go, because North, you know, they're not on the T side. They don't get a plant to try to get an early goodbye. They're on the CT side. Things are expensive on the CT side, okay? They've got a hustling and bustling economy. Things don't come cheap. And they put it all together just for a set of armor, two scouts, and a few pistols. We'll see what good that'll do.
Well, smoke does its job. Prevents Heroic from rushing in. Why would they? I mean, you've got your foot on their neck right now. Ooh, they heard that footstep in TCON. So they know that there were CTs by close B ramp, and they're going to be wary of somebody being in TCON. That may be enough, actually, to convince them to head towards Ivy. Seems not. Choosing who does which smoke. Smoothing out the execution here on the outer yard. But I feel like North have their hands full. Scouts not yet dealing any of the damage. Borup's gotten out towards Olaf. He's tagged, and there's Kierby to connect one to the head. Snappy struck between the eyes. Finally a response here from the T side. 30 seconds left over. These smokes soon to fade. Things are getting quiet, but MSL's done it. Another scout shot connects. He keeps this even, 3v3, Borup doing it as he may. 20 seconds, oh, up close. MSL grabs himself another.
Oh,
down with the one tap, but Kierby's got it back. It's a 1v1 with 10 seconds, and he gets into cover. Bomb back on Stown now, and he's going to have to plant, so he jumps on top of the train, keeping Kierby at a distance, but all he needs is one shot, and it's not going to connect yet. He's stuck in the lane, and Heroic take 15.
Now they pull that back. Oh, my God. It was as far as could be, but they went stretch Armstrong and reached all the way into the depths of the back lanes. Oh my gosh, this one tap. Big Stone. Oh my god, I want to see what happens on map 4 with Stone, because it seems like he's starting to get better and better and better, to the point that he is back. Is he at 20?
25 and 8.
Oh my god, yeah, wow.
It's the same guy who dropped like 4 kills across the first 2 maps.
Right.
Oh, but it's not over. I mean, North, they have nothing to lose, so of course they're just going to buy in with everything they can. That last round was so damn close, but he does it again through smokes. Trading these back, keeping Heroic in full control at the moment. MSL doing what he can. Gotta give the scout props, but another trade back from Gay. He can't double up, and that's the problem. North, they've been doing a good job in these force buys, getting maybe one kill apiece, but you need somebody to go off. You need a multi-frag to keep you in this. Low health for 4 of the 5 remaining players, but bomb's been planted, and this is looking like a 16-2, unless Kierby can claw back into this, and he can't. He's found, he's down. It's down with an amazing last couple of rounds. and Katie and ecstatic with this win.
They have to be. There's so much to think about. That was wonderful. Oh. On the comeback. Yeah, that's a tough pill to swallow. I mean, if your North looks so good on the first map, all the way up until the halfway mark in the second map, you still think they have it wrapped up. It's their map choice. They lose it in OT, heroic comeback. They stay stalwart. They stay confident.
Yeah. And more importantly, they stay in control the entirety of that CT side. A crazy series here to close out the second day. But you heard the interview with Estatag. He said, we want to take down North so that we can get our revenge versus Mad Lions in the finals, because that's the thing. This may be a great win for them in terms of the domestic conversation, but you've got a tough job tomorrow. You're going to be playing big. And big, in those first two BO1s that we saw yesterday, looked fantastic. Mm-hmm. It seems like the roles and everything within that roster is starting to gel. So, heroic, props. You managed to survive through a double OT on your opponent's map choice, but things get harder tomorrow.
They do, yeah.
Perhaps,
yeah. No, big, definitely, if not the most impressive team so far from what we've seen on, like, Mad Lions and them. Like, these are two contenders that are not teams that you can sleep on at the moment. So it's going to be very impressive. They can pull out wins versus either of them.
Well, Mohan, we're going to have to head back to the hotel and go to bed. Wake up tomorrow fresh face for more CS. But before you guys head out, make sure you stick tuned to see what our analysts have to say.
Well, the teddy bear was right, wasn't it, Maniac? That is your new intel.
Where
coming
is he?
Into. Yeah, where has he gone?
I actually, I'm very mad because someone stole my teddy bear.
Oh, no.
They want the info. They want the inside info for tomorrow because we have some incredible matches coming up tomorrow. But this game, we all thought that it was down and out after that first map win from North. I don't know how Heroic came back and did it. I'm so excited to get to speak to them because that was a masterclass.
That was crazy, honestly. When you asked me and I said that Heroic could do it, never did I think that a scenario like this would happen. Never did I imagine that Heroic could actually pull back from such a deficit on the second map and then completely dismantle North on the third one. And it's so beautiful. It has the making of a beautiful story because you have both Borup and Stavum playing the best maps of their series, of the event even, during that series. Not even thinking about Snappy and the ADP. I mean, it had everything. What a series from Heroic.
Exactly. And I mean, Stavum, I'm so glad to see him liven up and make it into this tournament, just fully invest himself into this and show up when it matters the most in the third map, the last map of the series. And he just completely exploded. When I think back at DreamHack Rotterdam, when I saw him for the first time competing, I was, this is a young superstar in the making. And did he show up?
It was absolutely incredible. I also want to give props to Snappy with his holds on Ivy on that CT side. They were so impactful. And it's insane thinking that his sort of caliber of player, he really was showing up.
He's so sneaky.
He's kind of sneaky,
yeah,
right? But
yeah.
I think this is where you see just a little bit of the limits of North and their T side. The fact that Snappy had such a field day as a secondary AWP, that's not supposed to happen. So maybe Smoke's missing a little bit, maybe Flashes. I don't know exactly what happened. But also Snappy wasn't missing anything. And any occasion he was getting them.
And I wonder if North are going to go back and regret letting Mirage go and putting the train through, because we know that they're a little bit more efficient on Mirage, but with MSL coming in, with North trying to rebrand themselves, find a new identity, I guess they thought, we've been working on this train, but Heroic were just a little too strong.
Yes, and I'm so, so excited to see what these guys do tomorrow. But if you're North, what do you kind of do coming off of this? Because it's so tricky. You were so, so close to defending your title and heading to the semifinals. What do you do?
But first of all, you don't think about it tonight. Honestly, and I mean it, as a former player, as a former professional, you do not think about it tonight. Because the only thing you can think about right now is how you missed that opportunity on Overpass, right? So forget about it. So give yourself a night of sleep. Talk about it tomorrow. And trying to understand what happened, because for us, it could have been a 2-0 North. It could have been 2-0 North. They had everything they needed to. They could have closed a few clutches here and there. But you know what? That wasn't meant to be, and it's actually Heroic making it to the semifinals.
Well, we were talking about him a lot up on the desk. It's, of course, Stavum. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us. What an incredible series. That is definitely the highlight of the entire tournament so far. How is the whole team feeling coming off of that first map where you lost? It was your map pick. Then onto that second map and managing to take that in OT. What were you guys doing there?
I don't know, to be honest. Like, the map pick that they picked Overpass, we didn't expect that at all. Like, we think that Overpass and Nuke is two of our best maps, so we thought they were going to ban one of them, but they apparently picked Overpass into us. So we were quite happy when we went into the match. But I don't know, like, today I've been having an off day, I feel like as an individual player. I've not been playing up to my level, I feel like.
That's surprising that you say that, because we've definitely been singing your praises. But coming into that second map, was there a particular turning point for you? Because obviously North, they were still looking pretty solid. Was there a particular moment that managed to change the game for you guys and you really just found your headspace?
I think that Snabby did a really good job at calling on Overpass in the end. Like, he did some mid-round decisions that I haven't heard from him before. Like, it was really nice to hear from him. And then Cadian stepped up as well on the CT side with the AVP in the overtime. And on Nuke on the first map, like, I don't know, our communication was really sloppy and we just felt like we got shut down, and sometimes it can be like that on Nuke, so yeah.
Well, it was incredible to see you guys come back. And so I know the desk have a few questions to ask you as well.
Yeah, I have a question on for this train, just going back. I don't know if you're going to remember it, but in that sixth or seventh round when Cadian flanked ladder and he actually clutched the round, he got up and screamed and I saw Snappy's face and he said something. And I'm wondering if you remember what he said. He kind of gave a look like, all right, relax.
I can't really remember, to be honest, unfortunately.
Dang.
Just talking about Overpass for a second, that was an absolute crazy map. Can you talk to me about the overtime and the feeling you had on TeamSpeak? Because I'm sure the fans would like to know, was it tension? Was it pressure? How were you feeling?
We were feeling really great. Like, personally, there was like this 13 round or something where we were in a 2-1, and I did like a really stupid overpeak. And actually, after the game, like, I almost started crying because it was so fucking bad by me. Sorry for swearing. But I just felt like I let my team down, and it was a really bad feeling, but we managed to like climb back and get it in overtime. It was a really amazing feeling, and then we went outside after, and like I told them like how sad I was, and I was like, we're just gonna go win train now, and we did.
And you definitely did that so convincingly, but it isn't over for you yet. Obviously, you live to fight another day, heading to the semifinals, but Big will be your opponent, your step between that semifinal and the grand final. How are you kind of feeling? I know there's been a lot of emotions already, but how are you feeling about kind of going up and facing them, and what are you gonna be doing for the home crowd favorites?
I think Big, like, lately we've been having like the upper hand against them, both online and on LAN. So I'm just confident going into the match tomorrow, and hopefully we're going to face Mad Lions in the final if we win, and then, I don't know, we're going to be show the world that we are the second best team in Denmark.
Well, I'm very, very excited to see that. Thank you so much for joining us down here. It's been excellent to speak to you. And of course, we're going to take a look and relive some of our highlights from this game. Let's take a look, this entire day. Let's take a look at what some of these are.
So coming in with play number 5 here, it's going to be Cloud9 versus Renegades. And of course, it's Dexter. He's just dancing around this smoke. We've been talking about him all weekend long, and he ends up pushing that long A smoke and getting 3 kills on Dust2.
And number 4, we have Cadian, the man that actually uses the AWP as a shotgun. You don't need to have the zoom on, not always.
Definitely not. And with play number 3, this is C9 versus Renegades once more. And no, this is not C9 versus Renegades. This is Sprout versus Heroic. And it's Diha, of course. We've also been speaking about him all weekend long.
And now here we have Faven with the 1v5. That was absolutely crazy. Getting the bomb, going back to A and winning it.
Definitely so, and I've got all of them mixed up, but it's Diha once again. We actually highlighted his play as the number 1 play yesterday, and he steals it again once more as the number 1 play here for Sprout.
Right, his first 2 days in a row?
2 days in a row, yeah. And they're already knocked out, unfortunately.
Yeah, that's not going to be the case tomorrow.
Yeah.
Wow, I'm so glad that he managed to make that list, considering that he was an incredible player. But I'm so excited to be going in tomorrow. We have some top-tier teams competing tomorrow for a shot at that $100,000 prize pool and, of course, the DreamHack Open Trophy. What are you guys thinking going into tomorrow? You got any favorites?
The question is, are we thinking? Because right now, I'm not sure I'm thinking anymore. I'm more like living in the moment. I thought that the Stavn interview was so emotional, so cute. When he said, you know, I let my team down. I mean, it's part of the experience. It's part of being a professional. You're going to make mistakes in crucial rounds, and it happens. And I think it's great that the team stepped up and helped team get back into the game, because this third map was by far the best of the event for him. And if that prefaces what's going to happen tomorrow, that's really good for them.
Yeah, that's what surprised me so much. He was so emotional coming off of that and just saying, I feel like I've let my team down. No, he definitely did not. He was instrumental in that third map win. But of course, we're going to take a look at our MVP of the day. And I believe this is a member of Heroic. It could be none other than Esser Tag. It's done such good work today and been so instrumental in the team's success.
He definitely has. And I mean, although they did end up losing that nuke, man, Essetag, the way he plays off his teammates and just his understanding and game sense, it is spectacular to watch. If he shows up like this tomorrow along with Stavin, Heroic are looking in good shape.
Yeah, I mean, he was absolutely impressive. And just to mention Heroic again, the fact that we had today Borup performing, Stavin in the third map, then Essetag as well, our MVP quite logically today, well, you end up with a roster that is globally very dangerous, as I see an old friend of mine is back in the chat.
Yes, the analyst Teddy, who's been giving you the insider information. I thought this could be a trophy maybe for the prediction winner. And of course, it's you, Maniac. Well done. I haven't actually been counting, but I'm just going to take it as Maniac has won.
I probably should just pat him on the head. Missing my cat. Anyway.
Well, thank you so much, everybody, who has joined us today for the second day of DreamHack Open Live. So again, thank you so much to our sponsors, Intel, Corsair, and of course, Monster Energy. This has been an absolutely incredible day, and more action will continue tomorrow as we head into the semifinals and, of course, that grand final. Make sure you join us then.